Hi everyone, and welcome back to another Film Impact video tutorial. Today I'm gonna show you how to create this beautiful logo reveal using this logo. And I've already set up the logo as a layered Photoshop file. So if you don't know how to do this, there's a separate video tutorial on how to convert an EPS file to a layered Photoshop file. So check that out if you don't know how to do that. In this case, I have a Photoshop file with all the separate elements being spread out here as separate layers. So most importantly is the orange and the black element. And of course, I've got all the text, all individual letters, all being separated out on the tracks. And what I've done is create capitals to know the company name letters versus their your slogan goes here. So this is a Photoshop file with full HD resolution, and let's bring that over to Premiere Pro and create that beautiful logo reveal. So going to Premiere Pro and let's import. So right click, import, and get the PSD file, import. Now, Premiere is asking what to do with this Photoshop file. And I'd recommend importing it as a sequence. This way you'll get a chance to work with all the different layers here. So press OK. And now it's creating a folder with all the different layers spread out and a sequence. And if you want to search for sequence, just type in sequence. So, and by double clicking that, you'll see that it has opened up the logo. But since this has a transparent background, let's create a light background just by adding a white color mat. So there you go. So color mat white. And so mat white. So there we have it. Just drag it in there, and now we can see the entire logo and work with that. And it has over 30 video tracks, 32 to be exact. And the upper two are the graphic items, you know, the orange and the black. Together they make a square, right? Just in a 45 degree angle. Now, you kind of need to see what shall we do with this logo? Now, and since this is a square, just a flat square, I think a card flip would work beautiful on this. So so let's go to the effects browser and head over to the Film Impact Animations and get the flip. Just add a flip to the orange part, and there you go. So it's just doing a flip with beautiful motion blur. And when I select the video transition, you kind of want it to, right now it's rotating at a vertical angle, and let's make that so you can, so it's rotating around a 45 degree angle, right? So exactly 45, and see what it does. So that's good, right? And you kind of want it to, you know, the center point, where it's flipping, you can move it with the swing parameter. And I'm gonna do a, see where it is actually rotating the best. So here I can see this point, and I do it exactly between this open point and see how that works. Oh, that's beautiful, right? So let's do the same for the black object. And there you go. Oh yeah, that's good. That's good. But I'd like it to, you know, rotate in the reversed angle. So just check the box, and now it's rotating. And again, I'm gonna look for the exact point where it's. That should be around here. I can see it by the motion blur. So I can kind of see where it is rotating. Oh, that's beautiful, right? See how that works. Hey, and this video transition, these need more time to breathe. I mean, just stretch them up and even make them different lengths, because that will add some dynamics. So it's not exactly doing the same thing. The offset and the timing is just a little bit different, and this makes it creative, right? And if you don't like the bounce, I'd recommend choosing the overshoot and do that for both of them. See how that works. So overshoot. Oh yeah, that's good, right? And maybe even adding some extra amplitude there. So 7500, do the same thing. So here, make it 175. See how that, oh yeah. That's good, right? Perfect. Now check out what we're gonna do with the company name, the letters. We could do a pop that will just pop them up. Let's go to the C. This is the C, by the way. So this is beautiful. You can see by the first letters, I can tell exactly by the C that it's this letter, and add a pop to it. See how that works. So now it's popping, right? Pop will good. I think spring is a good one as well. Spring is a way to stretches, it bounce stretches, and that's like a spring element. So that's good, right? Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. And by hitting the tilde key, I can kind of see all the layers here and work with them. And so let's see. So here is the your slogan. We're gonna work with that later on. So your slogan, that's good. And moving it to a side. And now we're gonna copy this transition. And I'm gonna press Command and then drag. And that will select the start of each element here and just hit paste. So there you go. Going back to the program monitor, and there you go. So all the letters are stretched at once. So again, we need timing, we need some playfulness here, and we can easily add that by giving all the elements some offset. So let's, on the keyboard, I'm selecting a bunch of clips and hitting +1 on the keyboard, which will actually move all the selected clips just by one frame. And you'll get a little stair-looking figure here in the timeline. And what it will do, it will actually start the transition just a single frame later, but it's creating that beautiful reveal as though it's flowing, right? It feels natural. So this is good. Oh wow. And from this animation, I think you need a kind of play with the timing aspect and see what works for you. I like the graphic elements to reveal itself first before I start showing off the actual company name. So you kind of you kind of direct where you're looking at first. So what I'm gonna select these and move them just a little bit to the right and see how that. Oh yeah, that's good. So there you go. You've got the first, the second, and then you've got the company name. And now we want to reveal the your slogan goes here element, right? As for that, I mean, these are a lot of elements. And going back to the logo, I mean, the subtitle is actually the least important one. So by creating a very dynamic reveal on the company name and on the square graphics, that's cool. But you know, the slogan can be revealed at once, right? So going back to the sequence, hitting the tilde key, and I'm just gonna merge this set as a squeeze them all together. So your slogan goes here element. And now what I'm gonna do, and this way I can bring down all the other elements. And now I can see, let's do a push. So I want it to reveal beneath the company name. So let's do a push. And the cool thing about this push element from the animation series, it has built-in cropping options. So now we can kind of see the text coming down. And what I'm gonna do is, so here, just select the video transition and go to the cropping tools. And crop it all the way from the top, unless you see, until you kind of see this, the text actually being cropped. There you go. And I only have very few space, so from here, and add some feathering to it. Feathering the other way around, so you can do negative feathering if you want. So just a little bit. So this is beautiful. See if this works, and not do a bounce. Let's do a Bezier curve, and let's see. There you go. And that's beautiful, right? And if you put too much feathering on top of this, I mean, you can kind of get that jump cut feel. So you need to be careful on adding too much feathering here or cropping away too much, because you want the entire thing to be there when the transition finishes. So this is good. I mean, we need a little bit more there. So I think it was around 17. Yeah, this is beautiful. See how that works? And now with the timing, just play with it. So you kind of want the company name to reveal first, and then your slogan goes here, and this feels dynamic. Let's see how that works in total. Yep, perfect. So I had a full res. Let's do a quarter res, just to give it real-time playback. Oh, that's working very nicely. Okay, cool. Now, this is a way to reveal a logo, and this will add that professional look. And you can go one step further, just to ignite your creativity. Because at this stage, you have a beautiful reveal, but you can make it a little bit more dynamic, and that can be done very, very quickly. Going back to the project, and you'll have the sequence here. Let's add another sequence. So again, right click, new item, sequence. And this was full HD and work whatever resolution you're working with. So this is the logo reveal. And what I'm gonna do is add the other sequence, just search for sequence. And I'm gonna drop the reveal that we've made till now. And for this, I mean, the background is put inside this layer. Let's give it a name, by the way. So company logo, double click that, and remove the color matte here. I'm just gonna cut away. And in this sequence, I'm gonna add this color matte. So I'm basically having the background already. Now having the logo reveal, that's good, perfect. And now we can add another transition. For example, do a dissolve would be very simple, but that's, I mean, something to start with. You could add that, but okay, dissolve. Dissolve should be my default video transition, by the way, so Command-D. So now it's doing a dissolve while it's revealing the logo. But let's add more creativity, right? I found something, like one you didn't expect, in the distortion sections, TV power. Let's add TV power and see how that works. Oh, wow. See how that, I mean, this is low res. I know. Just do a half, because this will improve my playback. But I kind of dislike all the coloring elements. But I do like the fact that the logo is being squeezed down and being revealed as well, some kind of old TV. This was an actual Philips. This effect was based on an old Philips TV I had during my student time. That's knowledge. You kind of don't know that, but don't need to know that. But okay, change the color. Set it all to black, and this will, you know, kind of remove all the colorization effects. And now, see how that squeezes and reveals this element nicely. But since it's actually squeezing the colorization out of the logo element. Something I would not prefer. So the colorization of the footage. Let's take the eyedropper and just pull that orange there and see how that works. And now. Wow. So that's cool, right? See how that works. And now you've got a beautiful logo reveal. Wow. Maybe shorten it a little bit. Yeah, that's good. I mean, again, play with the timing. See, I mean, I can spend ages on this, but the fact is, I've done this within 10 minutes, and it's a very professional logo reveal you can use, and this will really crank up the value of your editing projects. If you get logos and present logos this way, that will feel so nice to your eyes. I mean, this is very, very playful. Okay, so this is the end of this video. I'm going to show you a couple of other logo reveals. So check them out and see you next time. Bye.